registered dietitian. Today we will be making a spring roll salad. All of your favorite ingredients from your spring roll or egg roll all mixed into one bowl for a salad style meal. We're gonna start off with the salad dressing, and this is a very, very simple do-it-yourself salad dressing with a little bit of an Asian flair to it. The ingredients are a little bit of honey for a sweetener, and we're gonna start off with our olive oil, and we're going to use, a lot of times we'll do like a rice vinegar or a red wine vinegar to start a salad dressing, but I actually prefer using an apple cider vinegar. The Bragg's apple cider vinegar has a lot of health benefits to your immune system and your digestive system. So we know when your digestive system is healthier, your body is going to be able to absorb the vitamins and minerals more efficiently. So we're gonna start off with an apple cider vinegar as our base for our salad dressing. And the amounts will be listed in the recipe, but oftentimes as time goes on and you start preparing your own salad dressings, you get to play around with it a little bit. So as a flavoring to bring in the Asian flavors to it, you're going to use a tamari, and it's very similar to soy sauce, but this is a gluten-free soy sauce, so those that have gluten-free allergies or celiac have to be very careful of soy sauce because it does contain gluten. But the tamari is a gluten-free soy sauce that is very similar in taste. And this is also the low sodium version, so it's definitely worth going a little bit lower in sodium. This has 710 milligrams per tablespoon, so we're just going to stick to a teaspoon to start with, and you can always add more if it's not to your taste. Okay, and then we're gonna go ahead and add our olive oil. And our honey as the sweetener. And you just simply have to mix all of those ingredients into a bowl and stir it up or whisk it up, and our salad dressing is all set and ready. Okay, you can place that to the side. And our vegetables that we're going to do is mung bean sprouts. So they're the larger bean sprouts. You can get a variety of different bean sprouts in the grocery store. And the mung bean sprouts are a lot larger than like alfalfa sprouts, so you'll notice a big difference, and they definitely can fill up your salad bowl very nicely. Sprouts are always a great thing to add because they are an alive food, so the bean or the seed has been soaking in water to allow it to sprout, and when something sprouts, it's going to be growing, and when things are growing, they're always going to have more vitamins and minerals. We added our shredded carrots, and then we're going to add a red pepper. You could go ahead and add any type of colored pepper that you'd like, but the sweet bell peppers go really nicely. How I'd like to cut my pepper is I start off by just removing the top that you could always add as a garnish later on if you're making a platter of some sort. But then just simply, instead of pulling the center out with the seeds on it, simply cut around the seeds, and you won't even have to deal with them at all. Okay, and then the seeds are ready to be discarded. If it was a pepper that you actually grew in your garden, if it's in season and it's growing time, you can actually save your seeds, dry them out, and use them for planting in the future. Okay, so I'm just gonna slice our red pepper. You can chop it or leave it sliced, however you prefer. Believe it or not, each colored pepper has different phytochemicals and slightly different vitamin composition to them. So The red pepper has a little bit more vitamin C than the green pepper does. In red, produce that is red has a phytochemical called lycopene in it, and most of us are familiar with lycopene. You'll notice on the back of a ketchup bottle it will mention that there's an amount of lycopene in our ketchup bottle, because when we actually process or cook tomatoes, it releases more lycopene than just having them fresh. But the same with peppers, has lycopene in it. So we'll add our red pepper. And then our last ingredient is our parsley. So just grab a handful of parsley, grab it tightly together, and just chop until you get about 1/4 of a cup or a handful. Okay. So I'm just going to toss all the vegetables together. Celery is one of the things that you can choose to add or not, so it's an extra in this case. So I'm just going to slice just a few. Oftentimes people might think that celery is higher in sodium than the other vegetables, but there's a reason for that sodium content, and it really helps with balancing our electrolytes and our fluids in our body in a very natural way. So we have our vegetables. Just do a quick whisk to our dressing, and we're going to pour our dressing over our vegetables and then toss again until all of the vegetables are coated. Whoops. This salad actually makes a great side dish if you're doing like shrimp or chicken. You can always have this as a side. Okay, and we're going to, for presentation, pour it on our plate here. It's a very colorful salad, and it's all with fresh vegetables and a great delicious dressing, and this is our spring roll salad. Thank you for watching.